The Drive, brought to you by Huntington Federal Savings Bank. Local then, local now. Member FDIC.
It is Friday, January 28th. Your drive begins now on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. We got the phone line opened up for you this hour. It's brought to you by White Claw. White Claw Heart Seltzer made pure. 877-420-TALK. That's 877-420-8255. Now, we've also got the text line opening up as well. You can hit those digits at 304-523-2275. That's 304-523-2275. What do we got today on the program? Well, you know what we got today. We got to go over this one more time. We have to talk about it. We can't ignore it. We can't overlook it. We have to put it to bed. Marshall now is on a 10-game losing streak. The Thundering Herd on a 10-game losing streak. Marshall is now 0-7 in Conference USA. Marshall has lost its last eight Conference USA matchups dating back to last season. Of course, 0-7 now, 10-game losing streak. Is it going to go to 11? UAB probably going to be the team to put this team to the 11 mark unless something amazing happens. So we're going to get your thoughts on this one. Also, we are here until 6 o'clock. We've got some other things going on as well. The Super Bowl is a few weeks away, so guess what? We've got the AFC and the NFC championships. That's happening on Sunday. We'll have that for you right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. We've got our question of the day already up and rolling. You can find that on our Twitter account, ESPN 94.1. That's ESPN 94.1 on Twitter. And guess what? If you follow me, and if you're not, shame on you, at Paul Swann. I'm going to retweet it for you to make it findable. Then you can follow the radio station account, and you can find it yourself. I'm retweeting it right now, and you know where it's at. All right. Brand new poll. It will end in a couple of hours. When will the Marshall men's basketball losing streak end? Next game? In 2 to 3 games? 4 to 6 games or 7-plus games. So we have one vote. It just got posted a moment ago. And so Ryan Cirque has voted 2 to 3 games. Look, I know you have to vote first. I know you put the question up. You have to vote first, Ryan. I get it. So in 2 to 3 games is leading the pack right now at 100%. Why not the next game, huh? Why not the next game? It's UAB. So what? Big deal. Big deal that UAB beat Western Kentucky 68-65 yesterday. And the reigning Conference USA Player of the Week, Jordan Walker, hit a three-pointer with 4 seconds left to win that contest. He had 21 in the game. Big deal. So you can vote on that right now. And again, if you're not already, please give us a follow on our station account, ESPN 941 on Twitter. And, of course, you can follow me as well at Paul Swann. So we're going to get all of that stuff going. We're going to fire up the text line here in a few moments. Dan D'Antoni last night. If you were with me last night on the post game, a lot of emotions going on. We heard from Michael Byers, and he said that one of the first things he said last night was, we did it to ourselves. And I talked to Andrew real quick, Andrew Taylor, after the game as well. He was the last one to come in. And I was kind of getting a feel from him, like, hey, you know, do you feel like you're right where you're at now, where you can bounce back from this one easier to get the next one? You know, do you feel you're at that point now? And he said that this was the game. They had a feeling that this was going to be the game. The Middle Tennessee State game was going to be the game that Marshall could win, get this losing streak over, and then just start working towards the rest of the season. Instead, Herd goes out, losing by 2. Had someone comment to me, this is all anecdotal, this is someone in the office comment to me and said that I left the game angry or upset, left the game upset. I'm like, well, what did it to you? And it was, they found a way to lose. Not that they got beat. Not that they got beat by a better team. It's just, they found a way to lose. And so that's where we're at with Marshall basketball right now. They're finding ways to lose. And Dan D'Antoni, when we talked to him last night, he came out and he said we should have had that one. That was one of the first things he says. Should have had that one. And he admits that the team did not execute at the end.
Oh, Lordy, 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 Lordy. What can I say? Man, we should have had that one. Should have had it. It was on us. Could have had a few more breaks at the end, brother. The other guys that are out there. But didn't happen. But it was still on us. We had two fouls. They're not even trying to score yet. 4 points. You know, let's say you make one, miss one. We win the game. We've worked all week on flares. Supposed to make the call. Flare, flare. We're at practice. We did it. The guy that's supposed to call flare says, up, up. And our guy goes under it and they score in practice. We jump all over. You say flare, so he knows to go over. Flare. Come to this game. Biggest point of the game. Up, up, up. He goes under. Three.
Someone called me yesterday on our post game. That was one of the first things that they wanted to call out and said, look, if the players aren't doing that, why didn't Dan yell it? Why didn't Dan yell it out? Flare, flare, flare. So a lot of Herd fans love Dan D'Antoni, but there have been more things that have been questioned about him in a long time as far as I can remember during his time here at Marshall as the head coach. So Dan, not happy. I'll give him credit, though. He's saying the right things as far as, look, I'm not quitting. I'm not giving up. You don't want to hear, like, look, we're just going to pack it in. We're done. We're going to play this string out. You're not going to hear that. But Doc Dan talked about his mentality during this losing streak.
Oh, Lordy, 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 Lordy. I'm going to come out of here Friday. I'm going to work as hard as I can. I'm going to be enthusiastic. And to be honest with you, the way I feel right now, this is part of living. You know, this is what makes this game fun. And I know that sounds strange when you're mad and it hurts. But when you step back, this is what this is about. This is what I crave, is being in moments that I can get really excited. I can get really down. And I get to come out tomorrow and try to get better. You can't ask for anything more than that.
I don't know how you take to that. So I want to ask, what do you think of what Dan's saying? Are you on board? Are you with him? Text line 304-523-2275. That's 304-523-2275. I want to get ready to get better tomorrow. Already, I've kind of thought about today's show thinking, okay, I'm going to get better tomorrow. We're going to do things better tomorrow. We're going to do things better the next segment. But winning also feels good, and I would love to get better as a winner. And Dan's trying to get this team back to the point where they feel like they're getting better and they're also winning. So it's going to be tough against UAB. That's coming up tomorrow. We'll go on the air at 6 o'clock. You can listen to it right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930 and 93.7 The Dog. Yesterday also, the Marshall women go on the road and just got almost lost by 40, by 1 point, 80-41. 39-point loss. Ouch. That's all I can say. I think this team can bounce back. I don't think this team will take this long. It will bounce back. So I'm looking forward to seeing what the women can do tomorrow against UAB. The men, of course, at the Cam Henderson Center. If Marshall can put it together and shoot well, put it together, do the things that it needs to do, improve upon what you did against Middle. I mean, you shot in this contest, if you're looking at Marshall, 46.2%, 24-52. 3-point line, 10 of 22 for 45.5%. You led for 34 minutes. You had a lead majority of the game. You just couldn't hang on to it. You found a way to lose. The crowd was there for you, just about. I mean, it wasn't the biggest crowd. It wasn't the smallest crowd either. I mean, it was almost on average. 3,864 showed up. It'll be a bigger crowd on Saturday. The Thursday crowd seemed to be smaller than the Saturday crowds. So you'll have more people there, I'm sure. And UAB is a good team. Yeah, you want to go watch them. It'll be a fun game, I would think. Or at least it'll be fun to watch UAB. I mean, they're really good. They're really good right now. So we'll talk about that. We'll get your thoughts in again, 304-523-2275. That's 304-523-2275. You can also join us the old-fashioned way. That's right. We got the phone line open for you, 877-420-TALK, 877-420-8255. We'll talk a little bit about UAB. We'll break this one down a little bit more. We'll kind of eyeball a few things from the box score, things that maybe stood out to me, things that stand out to you. We've got the question going on now on our Twitter account, ESPN94.1. You know, we're asking you, when will Marshall end the losing streak? You have next game, you have in 2 to 3 games, 4 to 6 games, or 7-plus games. You got all show to vote on that one. And, of course, you can find me on Twitter at Paul Swann. I've retweeted it, so you can find the tweet there and go to our station account. Follow us there. Really, really appreciate that, if you would. And we'll find out what you think coming up later on. More coming up. It's the Friday edition, The Drive, getting you set for the weekend here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930, presented by Huntington Federal Savings Bank.
Our phone line this hour, 877-420-TALK, 877-420-8255. Our text line, 304-523-2275. Of course, we're doing the Twitter poll today. We're asking how many games is it going to take for Marshall to win again. It's going to take the next game, 2 to 3, you know, 4 to 6, 7-plus. You know, you get the idea. We'll get that for you. If you follow me on Twitter, you'll find the poll question over on our station account, ESPN 94.1. If you aren't following me or the station, we really appreciate that. You can also text your response in, as this texter has, at 304-523-2275. And the texter writes, "Don't have Twitter, but Marshall's next win will be FIU in Huntington." I know Ryan's diving right now. He's like, "I don't have the schedule in front of me. When's the next FIU game?" It's going to be a few games, Ryan. It's going to be a few games. So the Thundering Herd next winning opportunity will be FIU in Huntington. So 4 games. Okay. 4 games from now, we'll see a Marshall win. I'm not sure that I can guarantee that. I'm not guaranteeing anything right now. Not until this team can win. I'm not guaranteeing a single game. And I'm not going to really say that Marshall's got a great chance against UAB. I will say it. Marshall's losing tomorrow against UAB. Marshall is losing tomorrow against UAB. And there's 2 things that can happen. I'm either right or they prove me wrong. 1 of 2 things. I'm right or they prove me wrong. Those are the outcomes that happen tomorrow. UAB beats Western Kentucky 68-65. 4 seconds left on the clock. Jordan Walker hits that 3-pointer. He had 21 points in the game. UAB is now 7-1 in Conference USA. They are 17-4 overall. You know, a couple of their losses that really stand out to me, you want to pay attention to. They lost to Rice. That was on January 8th, 85-80. Lost to Rice. You know, I'm scratching my head there, losing the Rice. All right. UAB has won every other conference game since. 7-1 in league play. They lost to West Virginia back in December, back on December 18th. It was a close contest, 65-59. And despite West Virginia's win and loss record, you know, they've lost some games, they've had some tough contests, I really think that West Virginia is still a solid, good basketball team. So don't boo me in there. I get it. You and I get it, Mr. Cirque. You and the WVU soccer don't like each other. Get it. Boomy in there. WVU is a good basketball team. Come on now. No, we can't say come on, man. It's come on now. Texters will jump me again. I can't say come on, man, anymore. It's come on now. UAB is really good. Averaging over 80 a contest, they give up a little over 60. And their win margin, I believe, is, well, let's put it to you this way, 17.5. I think that was the number I pulled up there. They also pulled down almost 11 steals a game. They're going to be good. Lee Conference USA in three-point percentage, 38%. Turnover margin, 6.6. As I mentioned, they lead Conference USA in steals at 10.6. It's a good team coming in. I mean, if you're going to get healthy, this is not the game you circle on the schedule and say, you get healthy here. Now, if you win this game, though, you'll have a lot of people scratching heads like, where's that been? Because this is the odds-on favorite to win Conference USA coming into the Henderson Center. UAB picked to win Conference USA, and so far, almost perfect in proving it at 7-1. So it should be a fun one. I would think it would be a fun one tomorrow. I mean, at least Marshall was able to keep up with Middle. I mean, Marshall led this game. I mean, what am I talking about, keep up? They led this game for almost 35 minutes. It was 34 minutes plus they led this one. And there were some good minutes out there. Scratching her head on some decisions, were like, where's Darius George? But Andrew Taylor, 22 points, 8 of 14, 4 of 6 from the three-point line, 37 minutes. Tavion Kinsey, 18 points, and I'm good with that line, 18 points, 3 of 10 from the field, maybe not his best field percentage, missed his only three-pointer. Had 12 of 13 makes from the free throw line. So he got his points from the free throw line. That's good. I'll take that. I'll take that kind of production every time. If he's getting sent to the line, I'm taking it. If he's making it. And then Michael Byers, I want to see more of him out there. Personally, I think he's a starter. He should start. 12 points, 3 of 8 from the field. 2 of 5 from the three-point line, 4-4 from the free throw line, had 2 rebounds, both on the defensive glass, had a block, 24 minutes, had a couple of turnovers there. You can clean that stuff up. I mean, everybody almost had turnovers tonight, or last night. Yeah, Andrew had 3, David Early had 2, Tavion had 5, Obina had 1, Kyle Braun had 1. I was looking at assists. Let me move one column over. I do apologize. Andrew Taylor had 3. See, that's where I skipped. David Early had 4. Tavion had 2. Obina had 2. Kyle Braun had 1. And Michael Byers had 2 on the turnover side. The assists, let me clear that up since I was reading from that column. It's Andrew with 3 assists. David Early had 2. Tavion had 5 assists. I like that. I want to see more. Obina had 1. Kyle Braun had 1. Obina, he was out there 31 minutes. 9 points. Gorn had 5. David Early had 6. Maybe I can see a little bit more Darius George. Points in the paint, Marshall. That's where Middle won that battle, 38-20, points in the paint. Points off turnovers, that's one I circled yesterday, 25-10 in favor of Middle. Second chance points about even, 9-8 in favor of Middle. Fast break points, 16-7 in favor of Middle. Bench points, 29-19 in favor of Middle. Middle won all those categories. Every single one of those categories, Middle won. But yet Marshall led for 34 minutes and 21 seconds. Marshall went into the halftime leading 40-37 and lost 81-79. Middle outscored them 44-39. And Marshall could not by a basket and almost 3 minutes left on the clock. 2 minutes and 41 seconds left. Last field goal. Marshall could not buy a basket since. And Marshall led by seven. Largest lead was seven. Middle led by three. That was their largest lead. The Thundering Herd got some pretty good numbers. Just wasn't enough. Found a way. As someone commented to me, found a way to lose. So now, can they find a way to win? We'll get your thoughts. You can join us, 877-420-TALK, 877-420-8255. The text line, 304-523-2275. On Twitter, I'm at Paul Swann. Check out the Twitter feed. I've got the poll question retweeted, so you can find it. The Thundering Herd, going to win its next game? Or is it going to take a few games to get that first and next win? We'll talk about it more with you when we continue here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930. Brought to you by Huntington Federal Savings Bank, the local bank that's here for every step of your life's journey. Member FDIC.
Our poll question of the day: when will the Marshall men's basketball losing streak end? You can vote now on Twitter at ESPN 941. Is it going to end the next game? In 2-3 games, 4-6 games, or 7-plus games? How many games are going to take? Well, so far, none of you say the next game. That's UAB. None of you say that. Also, you're all optimistic. You're not saying 7-plus games, so you're not saying this thing is going to just go on for a while. Some of you are a little less optimistic, though. 4-6 games is 20% right now, and in 2-3 games is at 80%. So you can vote as well. That's our question of the day. You can pick that up on ESPN 941 on Twitter. And of course, if you don't have Twitter, of course, you have a phone. And if you have a phone, you can text 304-523-2275. That's 304-523-2275. So what's going to happen tomorrow? We're going to find out. We're definitely going to find out. And I hope that the women can pick up a win as well. That would be a great day. If Marshall could get the win against UAB, both on the men's and women's side, that would be fantastic. There's some other things happening as far as what's going on with the Thundering Herd. We'll get you caught up on that. The tennis team is playing host to Eastern Michigan and Murray State's on Saturday. Eastern Michigan is, of course, today, since it is Friday. That's the note I got. Yeah, this is the note. If I'd have read it verbatim, Mr. Sirk, Marshall University tennis team hosts Eastern Michigan on Friday. That's today. It's today, Ryan. Okay. I know the days kind of start blurring. I get it. You know, in the middle of a 10-game losing streak, the days start to blur. Saturday, taking on Murray State. So that's what's happening as far as that. And, of course, there's something going on this Sunday. I don't know if you've been following along, but the Bengals are taking on the Chiefs. 2 o'clock's our airtime right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Text line reads, "Hey, Paul, I agree all season beating ourselves with poor shooting. But last night we shot better and will only improve on making those trays. Been nice to get that foul called at the end of the game. Miladinovic keeps getting better. Obviously, we need to play harder and smarter and attack the rim. We will win next game at home against UAB and think we will break out and rain down threes. I'd like to see Darius play." Thanks, Holmes. Appreciate that. Maybe we'll see him. Or maybe Dan liked this lineup enough to kind of keep with it, to lock it in a little bit more. This is what he was thinking. You look at 37 minutes for Andrew. He's not taking him out much. Give him a break here or there. 38 minutes for Tavion. He didn't take him out much. He kept Obina Anachili killing him for 31 minutes. He kept Kyle Braun in for 21 minutes. He let Michael Byers play for 24 minutes. And then Goran Miladinovic had 18 minutes. Tucson had 8. So that's where Dan was thinking. This was the core of Dan's rotation. This is where he wanted to go. Now, will this stay the same or change? We'll find out tomorrow. Because I looked at the game notes yesterday, and the probables did not all the way match. And you can't really. Dan's not just going to give that out. Yeah, they announced the starters when they announced the starters. In Middle Tennessee, they went to the bench a little bit more. They used a little bit more of the – because, again, you don't see with Middle Tennessee, they have that one player that's just going to dominate. You look at the scoring. DeAndre Dishman had 16 points. He was out there 21 minutes. Donovan Sims had 17 points. He was out there 34 minutes. And then Eli Lawrence had 10 points, and he was out there 26 minutes. But they also had players out there for 14 minutes, 26 minutes, 23 minutes, 17 minutes, 19 minutes, 20 minutes. So there was a pretty good balance there. As I said, there's not that one guy that's just going to be out there the entire game. Donovan Sims, he was out there 34 minutes. He was the guy that was out there the most. But they bring in players and they rotate them in. You know, Dan, he had to keep Andrew and he had to keep Tavion in a little longer. You know, David Early, foul trouble. He was out there 23 minutes. He probably could have stayed out there a little bit more if he didn't have foul trouble. Tavion had 3 fouls. Goran had 4 fouls. So you're trying to keep Goran off the bench and at the same time keep him out of foul trouble. That's why you only saw 18 minutes. He contributed where he could. You know, the foul trouble, it spread out a little bit. I mean, DeAndre Dishman had 4 fouls for Middle. And, of course, again, you know, when you're fouling late as well, some of that stuff adds up. Keep that in mind. But, honestly, I mean, 17 fouls on the herd, 22 for Middle Tennessee. Wasn't like it was a chippy game in that regard. Wasn't like it was, you know, that physical. Text line again, 304-523-2275, 304-523-2275. Thundering Herd UAB coming up tomorrow. And keep that number handy because you're going to need it again because we'll go on the air tomorrow at 6 o'clock with our pregame coverage. And then after the game, we'll be back here for Michelob Ultra College Basketball Wrap-Up where we'll take your phone calls and texts once again. So pregame, maybe not so much. But tomorrow, post-game, definitely we'll get all your comments in and your feedback. I'm hoping we're just talking about a Marshall win tomorrow. I like it, just a nice little quiet post-game show. I come in here, talk about how Marshall won. Be nice, really. Just have a nice little quiet post-game show. Talk about the herd, hear Dan, hear some relief in his voice. You know, maybe Tavion has a good night, bring him out there. Maybe Andrew has a good night again, bring him out. You know, maybe Obina has a good night. Bring him out. Have a nice quiet show. That's it. That's what I want. Just, hey, you know the herd one. That's what I want. Just, you know, for the next few weeks, just like, hey, herd one again. Just monotonous. Just, yeah, herd one again. We knew they would. That's what I want. I want that. Just make it easy on me. I just come in. I don't make anybody mad. That's another thing. I don't make anybody mad because, you know, I say things. When Marshall's winning, I don't have to say things. And if I don't say things, nobody gets mad. Everybody's on the same page. We're all on board. Because when you talk about this game, like, oh, you hear what Paul said about the coach. Oh, you hear what Paul said about the players. You didn't have that problem, Ryan. I wasn't saying bad things about the soccer team. I wasn't, you know, you were winning to a degree. I mean, there was a couple of games you guys had some issues with. I'm not going to bring that back up. That Florida trip, I'm not going to bring that back up. I'm not going to mention that. FIU lost to FIU, huh? I don't, can you forgive yourself? Because I'm not.
I mean, I didn't think we were going to talk about it, so I won't forgive myself.
I mean, yeah, we're going to talk about it. Anything and everything we're going to talk about.
If we're going to talk about that, I wanted to let you know that you guaranteed a Marshall women's basketball win last night.
And I was wrong.
That's really good.
Yeah, I was wrong. Yeah, you think I'm going to say to Tony Kemper, hey, you know what? I said you were going to lose. And you know, after all the wins they were piling up, would that have been the right thing to do? No. No, because Tony would have called me. It's like, hey, we won. I heard you were talking about me.
Maybe if you guarantee a Marshall loss tomorrow, they'll win.
Well, I said UAB's winning tomorrow. See, if I keep saying, hey, you know what? Marshall's going to lose tomorrow, that'll rattle someone's cage and get them mad. They'll be mad at me. Just a little perturbed at me, a little angry. Like, yeah, you hear Swann said we're going to lose tomorrow. And then get into the post game and Tavion will come in and just say, hey, what was that you were saying about me? What was that what you were saying? Saying he couldn't beat UAB? Saying he couldn't do that, huh? Saying that?
But it's for the greater good of the Huntington community.
Yeah, so that ticked people off. Yeah, that's exactly it. I tick people off for the greater good of the Huntington community. So basically, you want me to revert back to my career years and years ago. You want old Paul Swann. I'm a nicer, kinder, gentler Paul Swann now. You want the old guy back.
Because people then, they can come together for a common enemy, and
me.
The common enemy being you.
So you want, instead of Marshall fans to focus on the losing streak, to focus on me. Man, let's not do that. Come on, they finally kind of like me, kind of. They kind of like me, finally. Let's leave it be. Like I said, kind of likely, just a little bit. All right. More coming up. Phone line 877-420-TALK, 877-420-8255. The text line 304-523-2275. More coming up. It's The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930. Presented by Huntington Federal Savings Bank.
Our text line 304-523-2275. Texter writes, stats are boring, Paul. Yeah, the stats aren't very good. Stats are boring, Paul. UAB kicked Dart in football. Payback is now, tomorrow. Take the big boys down in our house. Okay, so we're transferring some of that football hatred over to basketball, trying to get some of that energy, a little revenge. Hey, look, UAB is an up-and-coming program. UAB has really done a lot of amazing things. Here's a program that lost its football and got it back and has upgraded facilities, has a lot of upward momentum, wisely leaving Conference USA, getting out, going to the American. If any of the teams that were available at the time were going first, it was UAB. UAB is definitely an upward trending program, not just in football and basketball. So, yeah, they're the big boys right now. They're going the right direction. Football is going the right direction. Basketball is going the right direction. Marshall, on the other hand, you got football started. You got to work on football. Take away the last game. Just take it away. Football next season will look different than it did this season. So, Coach Huff is here. He's going to build that program. Football's going, I believe, in the right direction. And he's definitely owning it on social media. He's kicking it on social media. Basketball, we got work to do here. And, yeah, you know what? I don't know how to explain it other than say, look, Marshall didn't shoot well. How many did they miss? How many did they hit? And this is just basically the we're quantifying it. Yeah. But you can say this because, really, Marshall didn't get beat against Middle Tennessee. Marshall lost. Didn't get beat, just lost. Tomorrow, on the other hand, we're going to see how Marshall responds because this was a game which, you know, now you can see what they look like if they start to play better. Eliminate some mistakes, play better. Hopefully, Dan will come in a little bit more energized about this one tomorrow. And again, he's not too high. He's not too low. He's got a pretty even flow going. You know, you don't see him get too hot. You don't get that from him. You don't see him really just dejected. You don't see him really at that level. But after 10 losses here, you better be fired up for UAB. I would think you'd be fired up. If you are competitive, you would be fired up. Because UAB is coming in, best team in Conference USA. Beat Western Kentucky, 3-point shot, 4 seconds left. Good game, a lot of flow to that game. It was fun to watch. Just kind of look at a little bit of that game yesterday. It was fun to watch. Nice ball movement. And you got to look at that and you think, okay, that's the best team in Conference USA. They went into a tough place and won. Played well with Middle. You scored a lot of points. So you got the offense going back. Can you hang with UAB? That should be the challenge. So Texter wants the Herd to take the big boys down at the Henderson Center. I would think that the Herd would like to do that as well. So hopefully you get your wish tomorrow. We've got that game again for you coming up. It's going to be 6 o'clock airtime. We'll have it here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930 and on 93.7 The Dog. Our poll question is still going on right now. We're asking you how many games it's going to take for the Thundering Herd to get off this losing streak. Right now, it is, I'll say this. Some of you are not optimistic enough. You're saying 2 to 3 games, 80% still with that, 20% for 4 to 6 games. And you got an update for me, Ryan?
I do. It's now 63% in the 2 to 3 game range.
Okay.
25% in the 4 to 6 game range.
Okay.
And 13% in the 7-plus range.
Okay, so 13% of you that are participating think that the Herd can't get it done until well into the schedule. 7-plus games. Can't get that first win until 7-plus games. Some of you that are a little bit more optimistic, saying 2 to 3. Some of you maybe in the middle, hedging your bets, 4 to 6. I wonder if I voted, if I skewed this thing. If I said next game, even though I just said that Marshall's going to lose tomorrow, that would be contradicting myself here, just to skew the poll results a little bit, just to put it out there. So when Marshall does win tomorrow, I can say, look, see, I voted for you, even though I said that you were going to lose. So I've got it covered either way. Poll question going on for another hour. You can follow us on Twitter at ESPN941. And while you're there, if you give me a follow as well at Paul Swann, I would really appreciate it. And we will be back with another poll question on Monday. I think we should do a Saturday poll as well. Will the Bengals beat the Chiefs tomorrow? This should be the poll tomorrow to talk about the Sunday game. So, you know, who wins between the Chiefs and the Bengals? That should be the poll question on Saturday. So we'll have a special poll question on Saturday to talk about the game on Sunday between the Chiefs and the Bengals. Again, we go on the air 2 o'clock on Sunday. Party going on also at the Hall of Fame cafes. Going to be some rowdy fans there, I'm sure, at the Kentucky and Marshall Hall of Fame cafes watching this one. AFC Championship. This will be the third appearance for the Bengals in the AFC Championship, winning the previous two. Already won this game one time against Kansas City earlier in the season, not that long ago, really. So, you know, is it going to be more of the same, or will Kansas City get a little redemption? That's going to be fun. Whatever happens on basketball tomorrow, we got that to look forward to. We got a Super Bowl coming up, maybe with the Cincinnati Bengals. If that happens, though, I think we paint the studio orange. I'm looking at the guys going to be doing the painting. I have interns. That's what they're here for. We're going to get to see paint this studio. Just give me like a bright Bengals orange. You can just paint the studio.
I backed the idea until you told.
Of course you backed the idea until I told you who's doing it. It's going to be you.
Yeah, it's a great idea. I just,
fantastic
idea.
I mean, we got this, I don't know what this is, like, it's not even a, it's like an off beige. It's like, it's not even a cream. It's not even a country white. It's like this beige, I don't know what to call this, what it is. We need neon orange in here. This, if the Bengals win. If the Bengals win, the trim can stay white. Or, you know, maybe we paint the door black and the walls orange. That would look good in here. And then I can get Spencer Atkins to come on down and see how big of Bengals fans we are here. We can get another one of those WOWK stories. Have you seen my guy on Twitter? He's asking people, hey, are you a super Bengals fan? We want to do a story with you. And I saw one, and it's just like the man cave surrounded with Bengals gear. I am not into decorating like that. That's not me. I don't have like the sports cave. That's going to do it for this edition. For our producer, Ryan Sirk, I'm Paul Swann. Back tomorrow here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
WRBC Huntington, W231BS Huntington, broadcasting from the Oscars Breakfast Burgers and Brew Studios. This is ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
West Virginia Metro News, I'm Alex Thomas. Coronavirus hospitalizations decreasing slightly. The State Department of Health and Human